Welcome to our discussion on Pomella, Prebiotic Potential and Beyond. Pomella is a full-spectrum pomegranate extract standardized to both punicollagen and polyphenols. Our discussion will include skin wrinkling and the skin-gut microbiome, applications for supporting healthy blood sugar and cardiovascular health, as well as antioxidant properties and much more. When we consume Pomella, the punicollagen undergoes acid and enzyme hydrolysis, forming ellagic acid and punicalin. At that juncture in the gastric environment, it passes into the intestine, where the gut microbiota convert ellagic acid to derivative metabolites, including urolithin. Then it passes on through the 60,000 miles of blood vessels, pumped via a heart that beats about 100,000 times a day, to the target tissues, the trillions of cells within the body that may benefit from increased antioxidant and other clinical impacts. The biological effects of Pomella in vitro were studied in 2014, and it showed that the pomegranate phenolics inhibit the formation of advanced glycation end products. This is particularly important in clinical practice, as both metabolic syndrome and diabetes run rampant in the westernized world. As you can see, that compared to aminoguanidine, both punicollagen as well as ellagic acid had a potent effect relative to the fluorescent intensity. On the far right-hand upper corner, you can see the percent inhibition of glycation, and you can see the pomegranate extract, Pomella, actually had a very potent effect against aminoguanidine. The aminoguanidine is the control in this case, and is very potent for helping quench and negate advanced glycation end products. You can also see in the bottom right-hand graph, punicollagen, ellagic acid, gallic acid, and metabolites like urolithin A and B, and its impact, once again, on advanced glycation. So in clinical practice, we have the antioxidant capacity, but we also have the ability to help mitigate some of the advanced glycation end products. And if we think of HA1C, long-term blood sugar control, we measure 3 to 4 months of blood sugar damage that occurs to the hemoglobin and red blood cells. Now, if you were to think of air pop popcorn as a healthy cell, non-GMO, of course, and then, of course, we add a little sugar, we get kettle corn, a little bit more, we get caramel corn, and if we have a lot of sugar, let's say out of control blood sugar, maybe we get Cracker Jacks. The goal is to keep our cells functional and not to allow glycation to lead to accelerated aging and inflammatory aging. So the PK studies that have been done were with 250 and 1,000 milligrams. This was done by Yates in 2023. Ellagic acid, urolithin A, B, with and without enzyme hydrolysis. Remembering in the gastric environment, hydrolysis and enzyme activity were important for the conversion of punicollagen to ellagic acid, and then further on through microbial metabolism in the gut, the creation of metabolites, including urolithin. So we see also in a 2006 study, 800 milligrams was used, and both the C and Tmax for ellagic acid and plasma were determined as 33.8 plus or minus 12.7 nanograms per ml at 1 hour. So we know that when consumed, there is an impact and a shift, and it's all about ultimately in clinical practice, plasma serum levels and getting to the target tissues. Something's only as good as its absorption. When we look at Pomella in a study on skin, we see the biophysical features and an alteration of the gut-skin axis, but also very important, skin wrinkles. Once again, we term it beauty from within. We go to any social function, and whether we're supposed to or not, we do see or judge a person by how they present. Are they radiant? Are they drawn? Are they tired? And once again, the healthier we are on the inside, once again, cells, likewise, the cells on the outside of our body, our skin, reflect inner well-being. In a double-blind, placebo-controlled randomized trial, 1 250-milligram Pomella containing 75 milligrams of punicollagen per capsule and an oral placebo were given. It was given over 4 weeks in a population of 18 healthy males and females aged 25 to 55. The parameters include looking at facial appearance changes and severity, changes in the facial biophysical properties, such as sebum production, the transepidermal water loss, TEWL, melanin, as well as erythema, the redness, shift in the gut and skin microbiome, very important, and shift in blood short-chain fatty acids, also vitally important, as we'll discuss as we proceed. I do also want to point in 2014, pomegranate antioxidant capacity was reported to be the highest among several nutritional supplements, including milk thistle, green tea, grapeseed, goji, and acai. When we look at the skin microbiome, we have to realize that it, much like the GI tract, is a collective of friendly bacteria and unfriendly bacteria. So eubiosis, a term we rarely use, eu meaning good, and dysbiosis, a term we use far too often. So the goal is to create a healthy environment. Well, through whole sequencing of the stool sample and a 16S bacterial sequence of skin samples, bioinformatic analysis occurred. And they found that there's a significant enrichment in the abundance of the Fecalic bacterium and the Pomella group at 4 weeks compared to baseline. Also important is Roseberia, Coprococcus, the Fecalobacterium. These were all determined to be healthier relative to gut presence. The Fecalobacterium also plays an important role in mucus layer in the GI tract, and as it applies to not only short-chain fatty acid production, but also potentially on tight junctions as we look in clinical practice. And intestinal permeability, also known as leaky gut syndrome, is vitally important that we have a good neighborhood watch, creating the short chain fatty acids, maintaining the integrity, helping with digestion, and as a result, allowing us, as Hippocrates said, all disease begins in the gut. That might be an overstatement, but there's a truth to it. And also, once again, whether it be a pomegranate extract or other good substances, indeed, food is our best medicine more often than not. When we look at the results, gut and skin microbiome diversity, short-chain fatty acids, and urolithin A, we look at the skin and we realize, much like the GI tract, it is a barrier. And when that barrier becomes altered and dysfunctional, we can absorb more toxins. Just like if we have leaky gut syndrome, we might consume more antigens, absorb them across the membrane, triggering immunological challenges, leading to more inflammation and aging in the body, and potentially altered nutrient absorption. We also know that their delivery of items through the skin, transdermal delivery, is very important, and things like parabens, phthalates, and other substances can cross over the skin, particularly while it's intact, but even more so when it's not intact. So maintaining a lower inflammation load, as well as, of course, having the short-chain fatty acids permeate the body, helping with cellular function. An interesting tidbit in clinical practice, as I do lots of GI work, is to look at, does the butyrate actually cross over the intestinal tract, so short-chain fatty acid, and does it feed the citric acid cycle? And we're going to see, again, acetate also plays a role here as well. We're fueling the mitochondria within our cells. And if we think of a cellular phone, how good is a cellular phone, much like a human cell? Well, it has apps, and the human cell has DNA. The DNA, or the apps, can only run when there's adequate energy to allow for the genetic potential. So we've got epigenetics, we've got genetics. We must fuel our body properly in order to get peak for performance. So the skin microbiome studies have shown an augmentation of staphylococcus as well as bacillus. And the Pomella extract supplementation had a trend towards increased urolithin A concentrations of 6.6% versus 1% in the placebo group. Short-chain fatty acids dramatically shift, with acetate bumping up to 38% higher compared to placebo, as well as the propionate at 162% increase as well. As we look at the impact of beauty from within, we actually notice that facial biophysical properties did change when people consumed Pomella. Indeed, there was a significant decrease in overall skin wrinkle severity within the Pomella group compared to placebo. Statistically significant reduction in TEWL, the transepidermal water loss, was noted in the Pomella group within the higher levels of ergothella within the gut microbiome. A relative decrease in sebum in the Pomella group is also higher in the Agarfella group, and we'll speak about that in a moment. And the genus Gondibacter, actually from the Agarfella group and family, accommodates bacterial species that are part of the human gut microbiome and can metabolize ellagic acid. So to look at it from a deeper philosophical as practical perspective, a healthier gut microbiome actually allowed for more benefits from Pomella, a pomegranate extract. So once again, food, we get more potentially demonstrated here from our food when we have friendlier bacteria with greater biodiversity. When we look at short-chain fatty acids, we're looking at several aspects of well-being. We have acetate, propionate, and butyrate. Butyrate, of course, is very well known in functional medicine because butyrate helps with GI integrity. But as you can see here, acetate goes from acetyl-CoA to acetate, and acetyl-CoA goes down to butyryl-CoA, and in terms back to acetyl-CoA. So we're seeing that acetyl-CoA, the beginning, as you remember in biochemistry, of the citric acid cycle, known as the TCA cycle, or also the Krebs cycle. And so what we're seeing is the fueling of that ATP-producing cycle, which of course shuttles off your electron transport chain. Very, very important. So having the short-chain fatty acids not only help create a healthier microbiome, whether it be the gut or elsewhere in the body, but it also allows for the regulation and support of homeostasis. After all, the body tends to move towards entropy without a consistent effort and attempt within the body to maintain homeostasis. And as we look at the stresses of the world, the food quality of the world, going out in the sun and skin damage and other challenges to the skin and oxidation, we're looking at what is termed allostatic load. So everything we can do to fuel the body as clinicians, researchers, formulators, and having a global effect is very, very important. Pomella is also very important when it comes to skin health and the skin microbiome. My 19th book is called The MMM, the Microbial Mucosal Milieu, and it addresses what we call the three M's. Once again, microbial mucosal milieu, but the little M's, the little three M's making the larger MMM. So we have a skin microbiome. We actually now believe to have a microbiome of the brain, the uterus, the bladder, and even the blood. So we're looking at all these MMMs playing a role, but how do we create an ecology or microenvironment for the mucosal microbial milieu? Well, once again, we are what we eat from our head to our feet. So as we see here, the gut-skin axis explained in the left panel as a healthy gut-skin connection is represented. The right panel, a dysbiotic microbiota is shown with increased intestinal permeability affecting the skin. Our skin are merely cells. So is it no wonder that if our GI tract isn't functioning properly, the cells in our body are going to be malnourished or inappropriately nourished? And the answer is of course. So what we want to do is look at the short-chain fatty acids, true necrosis factor alpha, nuclear factor kappa beta, and also looking at the kappa light chain enhancing activated B cells as part of the total burden, along with our ROS, as reactive oxygen species. My patients are always amazed when I say, your breathing's actually damaging your body. And of course, we know we have to breathe in order to support the body, because not breathing also damages it. But when we breathe in oxygen, and oxygen leads to oxidation, free radicals. But at the same time, we need oxidation phosphorylation within the mitochondria to make energy in the electron transport chain. So oxygen is important. It is a necessity of life, much like water, and of course our caloric intake. But once again, we have to support a healthy microbiome, whether it be the gut, the skin, or elsewhere in our body. When we look at mitochondrial health, it's important to remember that when we were 30 years old, we made about 60 kilograms of ATP per day. 60 kilograms per day. But for every decade older, we lose about 10% of our ability to make ATP. We get a little tired for most of us, a little bit more worn out, but more importantly, our cells aren't as well energized and they could potentially succumb to epigenetic burdens, diet and lifestyle included. Pomella extract offers antioxidant activity and is ranked amongst the highest antioxidants. Also, restoridin, which is a curcumin pomegranate extract, has actually been shown to help with athletics, support and recovery from athletic endurance activities, and supporting the body in general. So our goal is to support the body under normal physiological burden and also extraordinary physiological burden. So from a cellular perspective, we have our cells and they're going through apoptosis, cell death. This is a good thing, of course. If not, of course, we can have misaligned cells and cells that get out of control, but we want to have cells that are aging through the appropriate process. The mitochondria within our cells actually go ahead and generate 70 to 80% of all the free radicals within our cell. And how could that be? Well, it makes sense. They're little blast furnaces. They're creating a lot of oxidation and they're creating a lot of energy. But through that process of making energy, they're creating waste products, free radicals that must be quenched. And so as we start getting older, our mitochondria become older, and there's a direct link between our mitochondrial DNA and our nuclear DNA in the aging process. Pomella extracts with the pinocollagens have shown potent antioxidant potential, combating ROS imbalances and promoting healthy aging. And Pomella extracts ranks highest in antioxidant activity in a number of assays for ORAC onwards. And at the same time, 30% or 32% increase in blood ORAC ratings with Pomella extract in 30 minutes, a mere 30 minutes in a 2006 study. And in vitro Pomella extract reduced the generation of intracellular ROS and increased intracellular antioxidant capacity. And think about the skin, think about every tissue in the body, and wherever we have mitochondria, free radical damage is occurring. Now, thanks to summertime, exogenous skin things, we also have exposures from the outside world directly to our skin, including off-gassing of our brand new cars or our newly remodeled home and offices. Antioxidant support and beyond is very important. So they've done a cardiometabolic support study and they looked at 300 milligrams per day. These individuals were on their prescribed medicines. These were both diabetics as well as individuals recovered from myocardial infarctions, two 2016 studies. They looked at blood sugar at 49% improvement, HA1C, 40% improvement, HDLs, 215% improvement, triglycerides, a decrease of 47%, total cholesterol, a decrease of 39%, LDL, 21%, and decrease oxidative LDL. And oxidized LDL is something which often people forget. LDL, quote unquote, the bad cholesterol, one of many indices for cardiovascular disease, but when it becomes oxidized, it can actually become more adherent to the endothelia. This also, of course, ties into nitric oxide levels, the glycocalyx, and many other aspects far beyond this conversation. But one of the mechanisms proposed here is that it might be the microbiota and a mechanism of action is the prebiotic benefits of the Pomella actually supporting some of these functions, because we know generally the healthy of the GI tract, many of these other risk factors also come to rely on a balanced system. Once again, reflecting the multiple studies and research that have been done on Pomella, they've looked at the full spectrum natural pomegranate extract with 300 milligrams in patients for 30 days with cardiometabolic issues and 250 milligrams for gut, skin, and beauty from within. Non-converters, aka those individuals without the microbiota to optimally convert the pinocollagens, seem to, over a course of time, become better converters for Pomella. Pinocollagens can also hydrolyze into smaller polyphenols, such as ellagic acid, as well as cross the mitochondrial membrane, vitally important. We are only as good as the energy we have to run our genetic potential, in my opinion. And from a KCO2 transport of Pomella, the extracts, they looked at pure ellagic acid, comparing the amount of ellagic acid found on the opposite basolateral side of a KCO monolayer, and consistent with published clinical trials and in vitro studies, pure ellagic acid displayed poor absorption, particularly in comparison to a Pomella. It is all ultimately about absorption and getting the job done. This is what we look at as clinicians, researchers, as well as formulators. So when we look at Pomella, there's research looking at antibacterial, inflammation, women's health, vascular health, oral health, sports and joint health. as well as its antioxidant, cognitive support, gut health, personal skin, and healthy aging. There's many applications that we can think about for pomella when we think of the fact that indeed pomegranate is a super fruit and it has a wide variety of therapeutic capacities to consider. I would like to thank you for your very valuable time in attending this presentation. If you would like more information, you can reach Zach Wagner at vs-corp.com. And you can get additional research, access to the peer-reviewed literature, and or if you have questions for me as a clinician, my name is Dr. Chris Meletis, drmeletis@gmail.com, and of course I have a LinkedIn account, which you're welcome to follow as well. I wish you the very best, and together we are going to be the change of making happier, healthier human beings. Thank you, and take care.